In a previous video, we saw that BJT is a voltage-controlled current source when worked in a forward active region. We also introduced the large signal model, and we saw the mechanism of voltage amplification. Now this works as expected at DC, meaning at a constant VBE voltage, there's a constant IC value according to the exponential relationship. And that in turn, if injected into a resistor, will give an amplified voltage across it. Usually we're interested in amplifying time variable signals like audio, for example. The simplest time variable signal is the sinusoid. Any other signal can be seen as a sum of sinusoids from Fourier analysis. If we have a sinusoidally time-varying voltage signal applied to the input as VBE, then each VBE generates its own IC according to the exponential relationship. Since the curve is not linear, the output is deformed and does not preserve the sinusoidal shape. We don't want that. We need the output to be an amplified version of the input. The output should be sinusoidal just like the input, but with larger amplitude. By reducing the input signal, we can overcome the nonlinearity of the curve by using just a smaller portion of it. The smaller the input signal, the smaller the portion used in a curve, and hence the smaller the nonlinearity encountered by the signal, and the output is more and more looking sinusoidal like the input. We reduce the input signal until the signal sees the curve as almost straight line, the slope of the curve at certain point. At that situation, the output is completely sinusoidal. There is no deformation exists. So if the signal is small enough, the collector current can be seen as the input voltage VBE times the slope of the curve. But at each point in the curve, we have different slope. At the beginning of the curve and the lower values of VBE, the slope is almost zero and there is no output. At higher and higher values of VBE, the slope gets higher and higher, and hence the output current gets bigger and bigger. So not only we need to apply small signals to the input, but also we must bias or shift the input to a certain DC value so that we can get a better amplification. In other words, to get a certain voltage to current conversion, we apply a certain DC bias voltage to the input so that we get the required point in a curve at which the slope is enough for amplification. Then we apply a small signal to be ridden in that DC bias value. That small signal is amplified depending on the slope. The higher the slope, the higher will be the voltage to current conversion. That slope is called the transconductance of the transistor. Transconductance represents the strength of the device in converting voltage to current, or the derivative of the collector current versus VBE. Since collector current is changing exponentially, the derivative is also exponential. So transconductance of BJT depends on the collector current. As the DC collector current increases as a result of increasing VBE, the transconductance increases. So by applying small voltage signal to the input, we can overcome the nonlinearity of the device by dealing with only small portion of the curve. And the output current is just the slope at the bias point times the input voltage, rather than being nonlinear exponentially related to the input. So for the model we built in the previous tutorial, if we deal with small signals, we can replace the output current by the transconductance times the input voltage. Also, IB is IC over beta. It's not exponential anymore. The base current is varying linearly with the voltage across it. So instead of diode, it looks like there is a resistor between the base and emitter whose value is beta over GM. This linear approximation of transistor is called small signal model. It's valid only for small signals,